subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV.
India is known around the world for its cultural heritage and diversity. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. India hosts several festivals every year to commemorate the country's dance, sculpture and art. One among them is the mesmerizing Konark Dance Festival of Odisha. Held in the backdrop of Mammoth Sun Temple, the festival recently witnessed its 31st edition. Along with it, the city also hosted the 9th edition of International Sand Art Festival, enabling visitors to witness two brilliant showcases of art at the same time.
Decked up with colourful lights and glittery artistic pieces, the way to exquisite open-air auditorium situated in the backdrop of Konark Sun Temple was casting a magical spell on visitors. Popularly known as Natya Mandir, the auditorium is famous for playing host to Konark Dance Festival every year. Jointly organized by Odisha Tourism and Odissi Research Center since 1989, the five-day cultural extravaganza aims to boost tourism in Konark along with preserving and increasing the reach of Indian folk dance forms. This year, amid the pandemic, several precautions were taken by the authorities to keep social distancing maintained and avoid the virus spread.
For the first time, this is open for public. Though with a lot of COVID limitations, things have been arranged beautifully. I must thank Honorable Chief Minister of Odisha and the entire team for organizing this. And this is also going digital, it's going online also, so entire world is going to watch. And this is definitely a dream to be here in Konark and to perform here. So this is wonderful to bring the normal life back. Even we are fighting with COVID, but we have to defeat COVID by opening this with limitations.
This year, even two saw some mesmerizing choreographies in classical dance forms of India, including Odissi, Bharatanatyam, Manipuri, Kuchipuri and Kathak. A series of Odissi dances performed by a troupe of Odisha Dance Academy under the guidance of renowned dancer Guru Aruna Mohanty brought the audience on the edge of their seats. Denoting mythological stories involving male characters, the choreography brought out the devotion and grace of Odissi, very well defining the traditional aspects and touch of creativity.
ये जो एक कोणार्क फेस्टिवल का स्टेज है ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड जो हमारे आर्टिस्ट डांसर्स फैटर्निटी है सब इस स्टेज पे परफॉर्म करने के लिए सबका बहुत मन है और यू नो ये अपॉर्चुनिटी है इस मतलब इतने प्रेस्टिजियस स्टेज में परफॉर्म करने के लिए. सो यस, वी आर लकी कि हम लोग यहाँ पे इस बार परफॉर्म कर रहे हैं और अच्छा परफॉर्मेंस रहा.
Another thrilling presentation was in Bharatnatyam performed by a troupe from Chennai. Being a predominantly solo dance, this dance form leans heavily on the abhinaya or mime aspect of dance, the nritya where the dancer expresses the sahitya through movement and mime. During the festival, dancers enthrall the viewers with their amazing footwork and various acts representing mythological stories of morality, romance, and historical linkages with pilgrimage.
We always long for performing these prestigious festivals and all. It's very difficult to get opportunities, that too for these young girls to perform in this big platform. This year especially, we have not performed since March. This is the first performance on stage.
This is the first time we are performing since the corona lockdown, everything. So it is really emotional and it is very overwhelming, and that too performing in a prestigious stage. We all feel very happy to be here.
In these many years, Konark Festival carved out a niche of their own in the country's annual carnival calendar by providing a wonderful opportunity to the budding artists to make their presence felt on the international performing arts arena.
Sufism has entrenched itself at the center of cultural and spiritual life in India. Dargahs of Sufi saints in almost every part of the country are the rich reservoirs of this mystical tradition that preaches peace and harmony. This was recently witnessed at the Dargah of Hazrat Khwaja Nizamuddin in New Delhi that was thronged by people of various faiths to commemorate the saint's ours. Have a look.
Decorated with glittering lights and echoing with magic and mysticism, the Dargah of Hazrat Nizamuddin in New Delhi recently commemorated the 717th urs of the holy saint. Cutting across religious lines, devotees throng the Dargah to pay their obeisance to the saint of Chishti order. Amid the pandemic, devotees had to undergo thermal scanning and get their hands sanitized before entering the shrine.
हमेशा यहाँ भीड़ रहती थी, हजारों हजार लोग रहते थे, लेकिन कोरोना के चलते भीड़ अभी कम है. और इंतजामिया कमेटी जो निजामुद्दौला दरगाह की है, गेट के जैसे अंदर घुसेगा आप सैनिटाइज किया जा रहा है और बताया जा रहा है कि भाई नो बिना मास्क का आप अंदर ना जाए. इंतजामिया कमेटी भी यहाँ पर बहुत अच्छी है, यहाँ पर इसीलिए हम लोग आज आकर दुआ मांगने का काम.
Enlightening the atmosphere of Dargah during the urs were the spellbinding Qawwali performances sung in praise of Allah. The Nizami brothers, descendants of Nizamuddin Aulia and their ancestors, have been singing here for more than 700 years, which bring a sense of authenticity and genuineness to their commitment. It is said that Saint Nizamuddin had asked that there should be sama or musical festivities at his funeral procession, and the tradition is still being followed.
हज़रत निज़ामुद्दीन औलिया साहब भी उनमें से एक हैं जिन्होंने तमाम मखलूक खुदा की खिदमत की, उनको नवाजा, उनको हर तरह से फ़ायदा पहुँचाया, दीनी भी और दुनिया भी, आखरत का भी सही रास्ता दिखाया और दुनिया का भी सही रास्ता दिखाया, जो आज तक पूरे हिंदुस्तान में हैं. भाईचारे का पैगाम दिया, मेल मिलाप का पैगाम दिया, एक साथ बैठने उठने का पैगाम दिया, नफ़रत को हटा दिया, नफरत को मिटा दिया, आपस में भाईचारे के लिए पूरी कोशिश की, एक साथ बैठ के खाना खाते थे, एक साथ बैठ के मिलजुल के थे, एक साथ मिल के। उनकी एक मिसाल है हज़रत ख्वाजा अमीर खुसरो, जो बहुत बड़े शायर हैं, उन्होंने कव्वाली का आगाज़ किया है और बहुत कलाम लिखे हैं जिसमें मोहब्बत टपकती है।
Built in Islamic style architecture, Nizamuddin Dargah is a beautiful structure comprising intricate lattice screens and a vast courtyard framed by marble arches dating back to 14th century. Besides housing the tomb of the saint, the Dargah also has the tomb of Amir Khusro, one of the greatest Urdu and Persian poets. Well recognized for seeking truth, love and knowledge through a more personal experience with a greater being, Nizamuddin Aulia is respected by the people of all communities.
हम यहाँ पे 42 साल से आ रहे हैं, 11 साल की उम्र से, और यहाँ की सूफी संतों की ऐसी महिमा है जो इंसान की किस्मत और नसीब को पलट देते हैं। जो इंसान ज़िंदगी में बेचैनी से घूम रहा है वो सुकून यहाँ मिल रहा है, जो सुकून दुनिया में कहीं पे भी किसी दर पे नहीं है। हर एक जगह का अपना महिमा है, मान्यता है, मगर इंसान की अपनी एक वजूद, इंसानियत का एक पैगाम, मोहब्बत का पैगाम जो आपने पूरी दुनिया में फैलाया है और आज तक रोशन ज़मीन है, और ये फैज़ चाहे घर में बैठे हैं, चाहे बाहर है, चाहे किसी भी धर्म के हैं, किसी भी जात के हैं, सबको इनके नाम से ही फैज़ मिलता है।
These holy celebrations like Urs clearly indicate that the lesson of humanity and compassion that was once propagated by the Sufi saints is still having its roots deeply embedded in the Indian culture. Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
India's GMR Group, which operates Delhi and Hyderabad international airports, is gearing up for the effective transportation of COVID-19 vaccines by developing additional infrastructure. GMR Hyderabad Air Cargo and Delhi Airports Air Cargo are set to play a pivotal role in the distribution of vaccines through state-of-the-art time and temperature-sensitive distribution system. The state-of-the-art separate cool chambers in temperature control zone will aid in the transportation of vaccines. Several vaccine candidates in India are in different stages of the development of a vaccine for COVID-19, including Serum Institute of India, which has partnered with pharmaceutical giant AstraZeneca and Oxford University for the development of the vaccine.
Indian jewelers Renani Jewels, based out of Meerut city of Uttar Pradesh, have created a Guinness World Record for most diamond in a single ring. There are a total of 12,638 diamonds on the ring, dubbed as the Marigold, the Ring of Prosperity, and it weighs 165.45 grams.
आज से 2.5 साल पहले जब मैं ज्वेलरी का कोर्स कर रहा था सूरत में, तब मेरे दिमाग में एक आइडिया आया कि मुझे एक रिंग बनाना है जिसके अंदर 10,000+ डायमंड्स लगाने हैं एक ही रिंग के अंदर। तो बस तभी से इसके पीछे मैंने कॉन्सेप्ट्स चालू कर दिए। उस टाइम मैं ज्वेलरी डिज़ाइनिंग सीख रहा था, तो बेसिकली मैंने कॉन्सेप्ट्स बनाए, डिज़ाइनिंग की, उसके बाद धीरे धीरे चलता रहा, फैमिली का सपोर्ट मिला और ये काम हो गया।
It took the jewelers 3 years to conceptualize and design the record-making ring. They used 38.08 carat natural diamonds for the ring.
The previous record was set with 7,801 diamonds.
A group of 50 visually impaired people attempted a world record by weaving 50 chairs in 6 hours. The program was organized ahead of International Day of Disabled Persons to create public awareness about the potential of visually challenged.
We are encouraging them. We are introducing that this world record combined for UNICO Charitable Trust and Indian Blind Welfare Trust. Combined together, we formed that this world attempt record.
The participants, members of Indian Blind Welfare Trust, have been learning to weave chairs since they were children as a part of their training to become self-dependent.
A teacher from rural India won the Global Teacher Prize worth $1 million.
From India.
Ranjit Singh Desale from Maharashtra transformed the education of young girls at a primary school by redesigning textbooks in the local language and embedding QR codes for easier access to the learning materials. During his acceptance speech, Desale, who teaches at the Zilla Parishad school, announced he would share 50% of the prize money with the other finalists, meaning the other 9 in the final round will each receive $55,000.
Thank you so much, Waka Foundation, the founder of Global Teacher Prize, and its partner, UNESCO, for celebrating teachers in a great manner. And this is such a great honor. And I'm receiving this honor on behalf of millions of students, teachers, those who are working hard in these hard times of COVID.
The Global Teacher Prize, founded in 2015, is awarded to someone who has made an outstanding contribution to the teaching profession.
India celebrates a number of festivals that are a symbol of love and communal harmony. One among them is Maharas, a festival celebrating the love life of Lord Krishna. Observed every year on the full moon night of Kartik Purnima, the festival is celebrated with great zeal by all communities in Tripura.
Donning in their traditional attires, girls in Tripura dance around the idols of Lord Krishna and Radha as they celebrated Maharas or Ras Lila. Playing as gopis, they sung devotional songs throughout night at a local temple. This was the 222nd year of the celebration of Maharas, a festival that belonged particularly to Manipuri Hindus. But today, both Bengalis and even the state's tribal population, forgetting their religious and cultural identities, participate in its celebration, making it a platform of communal harmony.
अभी तो बहुत हिंदू मुस्लिम बहुत लोग आता है यहाँ पर मणिपुरी और बंगाली ये हिंदू कल्चर महाराष्ट्र लीला है उत्सव यहाँ पर कोई जाति भेद नहीं है ये हिंदू का महाराष्ट्र लीला उत्सव है बहुत प्राचीन से सब
हम इखने राज देखते आए थे और कुछ दिनों आशीने प्रथम ही ऐसे थी इखने ऐसे देख लाम खूब सुंदर इटा एक मणिपुरी देव उत्सव কিন্তু এখানে এসে দেখলাম সকল ধর্মী লোকই এখানে এসেছে ভালোই লাগলো আমার দেখতে খুব ভালো লাগছে
This tradition of Maharas started in Tripura more than 2 centuries ago when its Maharaja Krishna Chandra Manikya married the Manipuri princess, the daughter of Maharaja Bhagya Chandra, who has already been holding this festival in Manipur. When the princess came to Tripura, she, along with her, brought the idols of Lord Krishna and Radha and established the Radha Madhav temple and started this tradition. Since then, it is observed with much vigor and enthusiasm every year. Today, it is completely sponsored by the state government as per the treaty between Manikya dynasty and federal government during the time of merger of Tripura with Indian Union.
King regime, king rule, that there is a perform this kind of dance which is called Ras Mila, Lila. It was performed whole night and it was really performed by our Manipuri people. Manipuri community, as you know, Manipuri people are very strong, they are very faithful, they are hardworking, and they have good arts, and they are really faithful to the tradition and culture. It is all known, and Manipuri, Meitei especially, they are very strong culture, they really preserve and maintain their own tradition. So it was already 222 years continued this Ras Lila. And it is all, everybody appreciates them.
The Radha Govinda Ras dance is a classical form of dance and symbolizes the rich history and tradition of the Manipuri community and has been playing an active role in spreading love and communal harmony for ages.
It's been said that he who plants a tree plants a hope. With the depleting forest cover in a number of nations and the rising environmental concerns around the world, many organizations and individuals are taking various steps to create awareness regarding afforestation. One such small but significant step has been taken by a shop owner in Mayurbhanj district of Odisha as he converts the waste water bottles into decorative pots for plants. Take a look.
Environmental conservation has become a growing concern for people around the world and several steps are being taken to address the issue at all levels. At the local level, citizens are using a number of creative methods to plant trees and saplings at various places to play the part in environment conservation. In Odisha's Mayurbhanj district, a beetle shop owner Nabagana Behra has decided to contribute to the cause by using waste plastic water bottles for planting saplings.
मैं और सब बोतल ढूंढ के लाते हैं और गाछ लगा के हम सौ करते हैं और छोटा सा मेरा घर है ये साइड में चारों तरफ लगा के हम सौ करते हैं और जितना आदमी आते हैं कौन फटा उठाता है कौन देखता है बहुत खुशी लगता है हमको देख के.
Behra, a lover of nature and beauty, is inspiring citizens with his small but significant idea along with contributing to a much greater cause. Behra goes to a picnic spot near Baldiha Dam in his district where he collects plastic bottles with the dual motive of managing non-biodegradable waste material as well as creating something useful out of it. He paints these bottles in shades of blue and yellow, plants saplings inside them, and then beautifully places them all over his clay beetle shop. Locals are appreciating the efforts of Behra for doing such a commendable job despite facing a scarcity of resources.
आउ सकाळे से माने से जंगल पाख जाई से डबा बंबा एना तो पिकनिक टाइम होउची या बालढिया बंध पाख आम जंगल अच्छी से बोतल फोतल जितकी पानी आसी था टूरिस्ट मैंने से जो फिंगा फिंगी आनी था डबा सब से कोड़े गिरी नहीं आसिक से रंग करती फास्ट रंग करने से मैंने फूल गछटी लगाती फूल गछ लगे पानी फाणी ढाड़ कर माने बहुत सुंदर भावरे लगैछंती गछ गुडकु.
It is people like Behra who proved that creative endeavors like these could play a significant role in addressing environmental concerns and create awareness among citizens.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@ain.com. I'm your host, Shreya Savijay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.